Since the pandemic began, fraudsters have been trying to capitalize on everything from unemployment payouts to cures.
And now a federal agency says people are trying to get your money by asking about your experience getting the vaccine. Just another scam. Steve Nielsen joins us live with the latest on this warning.
Yeah, and you can add the Department of Justice today to the list of federal agencies trying to warn people about this. Here's the play according to the Federal Trade Commission. They say you'll get a list of survey questions after you get the vaccine. You fill them out, and then they tell you to give them a credit card for shipping and handling to send you a gift for answering the questions. And if you give them that, it's too late.
It's amazing how joyful you feel.
Right after Robin Lawson got her first shot of the Pfizer vaccine, she received this email asking her to fill out a survey on it.
There was some kind of like $90 bonus something.
She stopped before giving away any personal information, but many others have. Take a look at these screen captures from the Federal Trade Commission on different types of vaccine surveys. The FTC and the Better Business Bureau are warning people about these surveys, promising money or gifts in exchange for information about how the vaccine went. In fact, many people reported it to the BBB, saying things like they were charged a $49 membership after finishing the survey. Another said the email they got claimed they could get a $50 Pfizer vaccine survey reward. Yet another person was emailed a survey reward valued at $90. The FTC says to stop if you get it. The BBB recommends you check for anything, pushing for you to act quickly, look for typos or bad grammar, and to make sure you check the URL the link takes you to.
It hasn't stopped. I've gotten a couple more surveys.
Robin got her second Pfizer shot today and hopes the emails stop soon.
It's kind of insidious. Not good.
And Robin did everything right here. She didn't give any of her information away, so she was protected, and she alerted the FTC to what was going on with her. And that's actually what the FTC recommends you should do. If you get one of these emails asking you to do this, they say to contact them and report it as fraud. We've posted a link on how to do that on our website, fox10phoenix.com. Steve Nielsen, Fox 10 News.